So thank you all for coming to highlights of our year in poetry and poetics on campus. I would like to, just before I launch into a brief introduction of our readers tonight, thank some of the people who made this possible. Many groups on campus came together with great excitement to invite Coral Bracho and Elliot Weinberger here today. The Katz Center for Mexican Studies, the Center for Latin American Studies, the Department of Romance Languages and Literatures, the English Department, the Program in Poetry and Poetics. These are just a way of registering how many people are interested in following the work of the two people reading here tonight. Entra el Lenguaje begins a poem by Coral Bracho from the 1998 volume La Voluntad del Ámbar. In an English language selection of her work, published by New Directions in 2008, Forrest Gander aptly translates the poem's opening as language enters, registering the sense of philosophical depth, eroticized encounter, and lyric stagecraft that inform all of Bracho's work. Yet, one grammatical mood may hide another, in English as in Spanish, and the poem's opening, Entra el Lenguaje, may also be read as a command to enter the language. In a sense, every poem begins with this imperative. Let us go then, you and I, invites us, on some level, to enter the language. Verde que te quiero verde, enter the language. Kongshan Bujian Ren, enter the language. Leaf through any poetry anthology, and you'll find yourself entering language again and again, because poems, by virtue of their brevity, if nothing else, begin and end one after another at a dizzying pace throughout history, shuttling us across the threshold of language at a rate ordinary experience might not otherwise allow. The line, Entra el Lenguaje, remains itself, whether we translate it as language enters or enter the language, or in some other way. Yet we can never enter the same translation twice, because, as Elliot Weinberger observes, translation is movement, the twin of metaphor, which means to move from one place to another. Metaphor makes the familiar strange. Translation makes the strange familiar. Translation is change. Even the most concrete and limited form of translation, writes Weinberger, even the most concrete and limited form of translation, currency exchange, is in a state of hourly flux. Translation under Weinberger. Yeah, you did. It was great. I loved it. Translation under Weinberger's account shares a logic of exchange with both poetics and political economy. A merchant exchanges currency, and a poet trades the familiar for the strange. Though he's often read as a translator, an editor, or an essayist, it might be more appropriate to view Weinberger as a poet concerned with modes of exchange on a global, even planetary scale. His work, like the transatlantic modernists of the prior century, or like Coral Bracho's today, opens new routes for cultural exchange, political discourse, and historical understanding. After making its entrance, Bracho's poem goes on to offer us language for thinking through the parallel enterprise of poets and translators alike. Los dos se acercan a los mismos objetos. Los tocan del mismo modo. Los apilan igual. Dejan e ignoran las mismas cosas. The two approach the same objects. They touch them the same way. They stack them up equally, they let drop and ignore the same things. We're about to hear the work of two writers who approach the same objects: photographs, species, histories, embodiment. They touch them the same way, with curiosity, reverence, and wonder. They stack them up equally, ethically, rigorously, equitably. They let drop and ignore the same things: intolerance, ignorance, indifference. Through their art, they illuminate how everyone enters language and how it, in turn, enters us. Todos entran al cuarto. Todos lo observan. Everyone enters the room. Everyone takes it in. Please join me in welcoming Elliot Weinberger and Coral Braccio to the University of Chicago.
Well, I'm very, very honored to be reading here with Elliot, a most admired, wonderful, and loved friend. Thank you very much for the invitation, Shiku and everyone. Elliot is going to help me to read in English the translations, okay? Que caiga esa lluvia fina. Again, rain, but different. Que caiga esa lluvia fina. En esta oscura verdad que abre sus mantos y sus ebrias mareas para protegernos, que abre sus alas tristes para ahuyentarnos, para decir que sí, que caiga esa lluvia fina frente al umbral, que caiga como aleteo, como irrupción brevísima, como un mensajero que, empapado y ardiendo en fiebre, viene de lejos. Trae los pliegos, trae las palabras, pero el dibujo de la lluvia se extiende y no deja oír, no deja ver lo que está sucediendo. Y es que lo que se acerca, lo que nos habla y nos agarra de los hombros con fuerza, lo que nos grita y nos sacude, es la lluvia. Es el confín que se desdibuja. Tiritamos ardiendo frente a esa puerta, frente a ese puente levadizo que nadie baja. Nadie se apresta a oír. Esta verdad oscura, esta oscilante levedad, como el murmullo de un sinfín de murciélagos, todos tanteando, todos brotando a un tiempo en las despiertas galerías de la sangre, todos tratando de salir de las torres para decir que sí, que caiga esa lluvia fina contra el umbral, que caiga sobre los muros, que los vaya borrando.
We can jump all over each other. This translation is by Monica de la Torre. Oops, sorry. Let there be a fine rainfall. In this dark truth, spreading its cloaks and drunken tides to shelter us, spreading its pathetic wings so as to shoo us away, so as to say, yes, let there be fine a rainfall before the threshold. Let rain fall like a fluttering of wings, like the briefest interruption. Like a messenger who, drenched and feverishly ablaze, comes from afar, bringing the scrolls, the words. But the trace of rain extends itself, making it difficult to hear, making it difficult to see what's going on. The rain is what approaches, what speaks to us, and grabs our shoulders forcefully, what screams at us and shakes us up, It's the boundary beginning to blur. We quiver ablaze at the entrance of a drawbridge that no one lets down. No one is ready to listen. This dark truth, this dangling levity, like the rustling of countless bats, all reckoning, all emerging at the same time in the wakeful galleries of blood, all wanting to leave the towers. To say yes, let fine rain lash against the threshold, let it fall on the walls, let it begin erasing them.
Su aflorada señal. Si ríe el emperador, cae un filo que corta y divide el reino. Una mitad se hunde, otra es el dorado salón. Su risa es la flama breve en los candelabros y el seco aroma de la pira. Una llama que tiembla como un espejo, su aflorada señal.
Gonna trip over each other. This translation is by Tim Johnson. The signal of his urge. If the emperor smiles, a thread falls that cuts and divides the realm. A portion goes under, another remains the great hall. His laugh is the quick flame of the candelabras and the dry aroma of the urn, a light that trembles as in a mirror, the signal of his urge.
En la entraña del tiempo, el tiempo cede y entreabre su delicada profundidad. Puertas que unas a otras se protegen, que unas en otras entran, huellas, rastros de mar. Un otoño de leños y hojarascas. En su fondo, la espesura translúcida del placer, sus hiedras íntimas, oro, foliaciones de luz, fuego que enraiza en el metal florecido, y un musgo fino, incandescente.
So the rest of the translations I'm going to read are by Forrest Gander, and they're from this book, Firefly Under the Tongue, from New Directions. In time's core, time relents and bears ever so slightly its elusive depths. Doors safeguarding other doors, opening one into another, tracks, vestiges of ocean, in autumn of logs and leaf piles. At its core, the translucent thicket of pleasure, its intimate ivies, gold, foliate light, fire rooted to budding metal, and a delicate moss, incandescent.
Desde esta luz en que incide con delicada flama la eternidad, desde este jardín atento, desde esta sombra, abre su umbral al tiempo y en él se imantan los objetos. Se ahondan en él y él los sostiene y los ofrece claros, rotundos, generosos, frescos y llenos de su alegre volumen, de su esplendor festivo, de su hondura estelar. Sólidos y distintos alían su espacio y su momento, su huerto exacto para ser sentidos, como piedras precisas en un jardín, como lapsos trazados sobre un templo. Una puerta, una silla, el mar, la blancura profunda desfasada del muro, las líneas breves que los centran. deja el tamarindo un fulgor entre la noche espesa. Suelta el cántaro el ruido solar del agua y la firme tibieza de sus manos. Deja la noche densa, la noche vasta y desbordada sobre el hondo caudal, su entrañable tibieza.
From this light. From this light into which, with delicate flicker, eternity falls. From this wakened garden, from this shadow, the threshold opens to time in which the things of the world are magnetized. They take on time's depth, and it sustains them and offers them up, clear, round, generous, freshened and filled with time's exultant volume, with its festive splendor, with its deep starriness. Solid and particular, their space and their moment fuse, their very orchard of sensation. Like discrete stones in a garden, like pauses parsed inside a temple. A door, a chair, the sea. The limitless, inconstant whiteness of the wall. The few lines that hold it together. The tamarind casts its sheen into the thick night. From the vase escapes the solar sound of water and the firm warmth of those hands. The dense night relinquishes, the night vast and boundless above that deep abundance, its intimate warmth.
Agua de bordes lúbricos. Agua de bordes lúbricos, agua de medusas, agua lácteas. Well, it's about water and the movement of the water and the images that disappear. Agua de bordes lúbricos, agua de medusas, agua láctea, sinuosa, agua de bordes lúbricos, espesura vidriante, delicuescencia entre contornos deleitosos, agua, agua suntuosa de involución, de languidez en densidades plácidas, agua, agua sedosa y plumbia en opacidad, en peso, mercurial, agua en vilo, agua lenta, el alga acuática de los brillos en las ubres del gozo, el alga, el hálito de su cima, sobre el silencio arqueante, sobre los istmos del basalto, el alga, el hábito de su roce, su deslizarse, agua luz, agua pez, el aura, el ágata, sus desbordes luminosos. Fuego rastreante, el alce huidizo, entre la ceiba, entre el cardumen, llama pulsante, agua lince, agua sargo, el jaspe súbito, lumbre entre medusas, orla abierta, labiada, aura de bordes lúbricos, su lisura cunante, su eflorecerse al anidar, anfibia, lábil, agua, agua sedosa en imantación, en ristre, agua en vilo, agua lenta, el alumbrar lascivo en lo badeante oleoso, sobre los vuelcos de basalto, reptar del ópalo entre la luz, entre la llama interna, agua de medusas, agua blanda, lustrosa, agua sin huella, densa, mercurial, su blancura acerada, su dilución en alzamientos de grafito, en despuntar de lisa, hurtante, suave, agua viva, su vientre sobre el testuz, volcado sol de bronce envolviendo, agua blenda, brotante, agua de medusas, agua táctil fundiéndose en lo añil untuoso, en su panal reverberante, aguamiento, ulva, el bagre en lo mullido, libando, en el humor nutricio, entre su néctar delicado, el áureo embalse, el limbo lo transluce, agua leve, aura adentro, el ámbar, el luminar ungido, esbelto, el tigre, su pleamar bajo la sombra vidriada, agua linde, agua anguila lamiendo su perfil, su transmigrar nocturno, entre las sedas matriciales, entre la salvia, agua entre merluzas, agua grávida, el calmo goce tibio, su irisable, agua sus bordes, su lisura mutante, su embeleñarse entre lo núbil cadencioso. Agua, agua sedosa de involución, de languidez en densidades plácidas. Agua, agua, su roce, agua nutria, agua pez, agua de medusas, agua láctea, sinuosa, agua.
What?
You don't have to read it all.
I don't have to read it all?
No.
Just a line or two? Okay. What? I didn't know it was about water. I thought it was deeply confessional, you know? Okay. Water's lubricious edges. But I'm going to read the whole thing. Water of jellyfish. Lacteal, sinuous water, water of lubricious borders, glassy thickness, deliquescence, indelectable contours, water, sumptuous water of involution, of languor and placid densities, water, water silken and plumbeous in opacity, in weight, mercurial, water in suspense, slow water, the algal bloom brilliant, in the paps of pleasure, the algae, the bracing vapor of its peak, across the arch silence, across isthmuses of basalt, the algae, its habitual rub, its slippage, light water, fish water, the aura, the agate, its luminous border breakings, fire trailing the fleeing elk, around the ceiba tree, around the shoal of fish, flame pulsing, lynx water, sargo water, the sudden jasper, luminescence of jellyfish, edge open, lipped, aura of lubricious borders, its smoothness rocking, its nesting efflorescence, amphibious, labile, water, water silken with voltaic charge, expectant, water in suspense, slow water, the lascivious luminescence in its oily crossing over faulted basalt, the slither of opal through the sheen, through the interior flame, water of jellyfish, soft, lustrous water, traceless water, dense, mercurial, in steely whiteness, its dissolution in graphite surges, in burnished gloss, furtive, smooth, living water upwelling ventral over dorsal, capsized bronze sun enfolding crystalline zinc, spouting water, water of jellyfish, tactile water fusing itself to the unctuous indigo blue, to its reverent honeycomb. Amianthus, ulva water, the catfish in its silt, sucking in the nutritious essence, in its delicate nectar. The aureus reservoir, a limbo, transparentizes it. Light water, aura within amber, graceful, anointed luminance, the tiger, its high tide below the brittle shadow, boundary water, eel water licking its profile, its nocturnal migration, in silk matrices, in the sage, water between the hake, gravid water, the calm pleasure, tepid its iridescence, water its borders, its shifting smoothness, its enchantment with what is nubile, cadenced, water, silky water of involution, of languor in placid densities, water, water, its caress, otter water, fish water, water of jellyfish, lacteal, sinuous water, water.
I read from this book, which is a long poem, a fragment, and then another one, a small one. I'll read. Ese meollo así, se llama ese espacio, ese jardín. Ese meollo asible de hacinada ternura, ese delgado en vez. Los muertos vuelven también allí. De allí nos miran, nos reflejan, nos orillan a ver. Unen la luz del tiempo, las estancias abiertas, incesantes del tiempo, su entramado acaecer, sus desbordadas resonancias en el cenit de una alcanzada desnudez, este gozo que vuelve nítido, esta radiante hilaridad, esta risa que funda y su fisura, como un venero, un amuleto, la fuente oculta de un jardín. Este huerto, este rapto que heredamos como una abierta melodía entre la noche, como un destello, una pregunta. Este cuerpo y su sed. De allí nos hablan, de ahí nos llaman como entre sueños. De un sueño a otro nos llevan, de un sueño a otro nos trazan, nos transparentan como rasgos muy tenues en un paisaje, como respiros. De un sueño a otro buscamos la solidez, este fuego que enlaza, que perdura, esta pasión que arraiga, que arrebata y su acentrado contrapunto, este sentir que engendra. Unen la luz del tiempo, las estancias abiertas incesantes del tiempo, sus remontables laberintos, su abarcable acaecer. Este aliento, esta savia que funde, que transluce, que nos envuelve como un oleaje, como un acorde, estos contornos íntimos. Un giro breve del cristal, una arista de luz, una textura, una palabra, porque la muerte tiene en el colmado corazón de la vida enraizados sus vértices, y en ellos arde, en ellos cede, en ellos une esta espesura.
Okay, so this is from the long poem, That Space, That Garden. And I'm starting with the last line on this page. This is really great. That graspable marrow of heaped up tenderness, that thin backside. The dead also return there. From there they spot us, consider us, they compel us to see. They join time's light, time's open, never-ending rooms, its palimpsest as it comes to be, its resonances overflowing the peak of a completed nakedness, this pleasure that returns, well-defined, this radiant exhilaration, this founding laugh and its fissure, like a spring, an amulet, the hidden fountain of a garden, This orchard, this rapture we inherit like an open melody between the night, like a flash, a question, this body and its thirst. From there they speak to us, from there they call to us, as between dreams, from one dream to another they carry us. From one dream to another they trace us, they transparentize us, like very faint traits of a landscape. Like breath, from one dream to another, they search out something solid, this fire that enlaces, that endures, this passion that takes root, that enraptures, and its skewed counterpoint, this engendering feeling. They join time's light, time's open, never-ending rooms, its surmountable labyrinths, its embraceable coming to be. This breathing, this founding sap which transluces, which whelms us like a surging wave, like an accord, these intimate contours, a quick spinning of the crystal, an edge of light, a texture, a word, because death has rooted in the fertile heart of life, its vertices, and in them life burns, in them it surrenders. In them, it joins this thicket.
And the last one. Polvo de estrellas. De polvo de estrellas estamos hechos. De la materia del corazón de alguna estrella ya dispersa en el cosmos y aún viva en la memoria de su viaje de luz. De la unión de ese rastro que se enciende en nosotros y su compacta sombra. Del tiempo que reencausa e imanta. Un instante de fuego que contiene a la noche. Un espejo de asombro y su amoroso trazo en la furtiva vastedad, en lo oscuro, es nuestro aliento breve en la cohesión del orbe. Del núcleo de una estrella y su irradiado centro, de su ígnea levedad, su suave soplo. Muchas gracias.
Okay, this is also translated by Forrest Gander. Stardust. From the dust of stars, we're shaped. From matter at the core of some star, already dispersed through the cosmos, but alive in the memory of its journey by light. From the union of that trail kindled inside us and its dense shadow. From rechanneling and magnetizing time. A fiery instant that contains the night, a mirror of astonishment and its amorous touch in the furtive vastness. In the dark is our brief breath, its bond with the whole. From the nucleus of a star and its irradiated center, from its igneous levity, its soft exaltation.
I said exaltation instead of exhalation.
Okay.